welcome to the DoubleACS Daily News. The Massachusetts Department of Agricultural Resources and the City of Attleboro are asking residents to be on the lookout for the spotted lanternfly. The invasive insect can cause damage to plants and crops in the area. We spoke with Attleboro Conservation Agent and Environmental Planner Nick Wyllie to learn more.
My name is Nick Wyllie. I'm the Environmental Planner for the City of Attleboro, here to talk about the latest invasive species that has infested our area. It is the spotted lanternfly. So this invasive pest, first and foremost, does not bite, it does not sting, and to best scientific data that we have, it is not poisonous. However, it is an extreme nuisance. Main reason why spotted lanternfly is an issue, especially here in New England, it can destroy agricultural products and crops. In particular, it likes to target grapevines. That's its primary plant it likes to go after. However, it also will target black walnut and then tree of heaven. Tree of heaven is actually another invasive species. So if you have tree of heaven on your property, I would recommend hiring a professional to remove that tree, as it is one of the host plants for spotted lanternfly. They're a sap feeding insect, so they will attack crops. If they don't completely destroy the crop, they will severely stress the plant. So you'll find that certain plants that are attacked by the spotted lanternfly will become very wilted over time and may die if left untreated. To identify spotted lanternfly, right now it's going to be in its adult stages. It's about an inch long with some very distinctive black spots on its wings. For anyone that would like help identifying spotted lanternfly, we do actually carry some spotted lanternfly ID cards. I'm happy to hand those out down here at the Department of Planning and Development at City Hall. So be on the lookout for those. In the spring months, though, you want to be on the lookout for the egg masses. When they're laid fresh, they are almost looks like a white putty. They typically will attach to any flat surface, but you can also find those egg masses on a variety of trees and plants as well. As the egg mass starts to age, it will turn a dark gray. Best thing you can do is when you find one of these egg masses is to squish all the eggs and destroy the egg mass as much as you can. The waste product produced by spotted lanternfly can be one of the biggest nuisances. It's essentially a honeydew type of product. Gets very sticky and then also sometimes get very slippery depending on where it is deposited. When these flies are in swarms, they're not going to bite you, but they can just become very annoying with the massive amounts of honeydew that they're going to be excreting from themselves. They're not exactly a public health threat, but they are a severe nuisance and a threat to our crops and local agriculture. At this point, the Massachusetts Department of Agricultural Resources has listed our area as infested. And is asking that we no longer report any sightings of the spotted lanternfly. With that said, you don't have to report them to the Conservation Commission or myself. Best thing for you to do is, like I said before, squish any of the egg masses or the bugs that you find themselves just to try and eradicate it. Do what you can to check your property to look for these egg masses. We want to try and remove as much of them as we can. If you're traveling out of state or even out of town, whether it's camping equipment or, you know, if you have firewood that you just want to bring over to a friend's house for a bonfire, please check that for any of these egg masses. We want to make sure that we're not spreading these this invasive species to any other of our surrounding communities or other states. We want to make sure that we keep it localized so we can try and remove the infestation as best as possible. For anyone that wants additional resources on what to do, if you find spotted lanternfly on your property, the Department of Agriculture Resources have provided us with a number of flyers, both tailored toward residents and businesses. And they also have a number of resources online that are incredibly helpful about how to spot the spotted lanternfly through its various life cycles, what to do when you find it, best management practices, and all that.